Hey everyone, we're going to do something fun and easy today. Pizza. And you know what? This is a healthy pizza because we don't have that big, heavy wheat dough that's going to not be good for us. We have a little wrap. You can get wraps that are not made of wheat as well, which are really a healthier alternative, honestly. So that'll be our basis, and then we can top it with anything we want, but it'll be light and fresh. Wait till you see what we're going to do with this one. Let's start cooking. So let's take a sausage. This is more than what I'm going to need, but I like to fry it all up in advance and then I can use it in other dishes. I'm gonna make it into little rounds like this. You can get fancy and you can also put it on a bias as well. And it looks like that. So whatever you'd like, but I think for the pizza, honestly, I kind of like the little rounds. So that's what we'll do for this. And we'll get that prepared to fry up. And let's chop the shallots up into a medium dice. It's got to saute with the sausage. Okay, I have some butter in the pan. A little bit of extra virgin olive oil for an emulsification. Yeah, I'll put that on about a medium heat. And let's put in the shallots first. I like to get those a little bit more done so they don't have that raw flavor. Okay, these are rendering nicely, so time to put in the chopped kale. Once again, you can use any green that you'd like, spinach, kale. You can even do lettuce. That's what they do in Europe. Over here in the States, not so much, but anything is green. But they'll tell you, the spinach or kale is wonderful color and also nutritional value. Time for the sausage. A little bit of butter, a little pat here. Let that melt down a little bit before we put in our oil. I like to do an emulsification once again for this as well. It's good flavor. It also doesn't burn so quickly. And you can use extra virgin olive oil if you do the emulsification with butter so that it doesn't burn, as long as it's not over high heat once again. So that being said, yeah, this is gonna smell really good. Sausage, come on, really? You can do anything you want actually for toppings and any kind of sausage. This is Korean barbecue sausage, which is really cool stuff. I've used duck sausage before, which is amazing. Whatever you'd like. Okay, this is the sauce. These little organic baby tomatoes. These are grapes. You could use any small ones you'd like, but try to make it organic if you can. And you can. I know you can. I have faith in you. Ooh, look at that little guy squeal. So what you want to do is put a little bit of herbs de Provence. A nice pinch. Good healthy pinch. That's really going to ramp up the flavor on these guys once you start to... my trusty spoon. Swirl them around the pan. You want to blister them. They're already starting to turn a little bit. And when you take a bite, it'll be an amazing flavor in your mouth on this pizza, an explosion of flavor. Blistering really nicely. Almost done, folks. I also have the oven preheating so we can pre-bake our wrap. Okay, here's a little secret. Once again, pre-baking this so that it can stay crisp. And get crisp, otherwise you would need that 900 degree oven that we all don't have unless you bake pizzas for a living. But anyway, but a little bit of powder, the onion powder on top first, also a touch of garlic powder, and that's going to really ramp up the flavor. This is a little secret, please don't tell anybody, it's just between you and me, okay? Anyway, let's put this in. If you have a pizza peel, it works really better once you put the toppings on, because it won't fall off all the granulated garlic and the onion. So let's put this in until it gets slightly crispy. Won't take long. We'll check it in a couple of minutes. Yeah, it's got a little bit of color to it. This is hot. Don't try this at home. All right, let's build our pizza. First, we'll start with the cheese. We will layer it very nicely right across so that it's covering the vast majority. And you almost can't have enough cheese, can you? Love this stuff. Once again, you can use any cheese that you'd like. And the next layer would be the onions. You can use a little spoon to put this on top, but let's use the hands, folks. You can really put it on so much more effectively, exactly where you want it. You gotta get right in there when you're cooking. Don't be shy. Okay, that looks pretty good, huh? What do you think? Now let's add a few of the tomatoes. Put them willy-nilly, yet so that it's a nice presentation. Some tart out the edge over there, maybe. I think that's good. And some of the sausage, of course. And plenty of that. It's already really looking good, but wait till it melts and it all comes together. Okay, in the oven it goes. So I have the oven at 350, and once again, it's pre-baked the crust, so it's already a little crisp, and it's gonna hold up to everything, all the ingredients. So let's just put this in for, it's probably going to be about another 7 minutes. We'll keep an eye on it so it doesn't burn. All right. Beautiful, oh my goodness. And the aroma, fabulous, it's unbelievable. I can't wait to watch into this. It is so light and refreshing for a pizza. It's amazing, it's actually healthy for you. Let's put a little bit of Herbes de Provence on top, just the Gilda Lily. Some people actually will take a little bit of olive oil just to drizzle it as well, whatever you'd like. Anyway, you're gonna love this, and it's really light. So enjoy cooking in the kitchen with your family and friends and make memories that'll last a lifetime. Have this one with a beer. Take care.